total cost of 1 kg onion is 36. Everyone can see that, right?
Yes.
Right? And we are asking for 4 by 6 kg. So what is the first step? We divided this bag into 6 parts. Each part can carry how much? 1 by 6 kgs. So together, all together, how much can they carry? If I take all the parts, what is the total capacity? 6 by 6 can also be written as
1,
right? So 1 kg we can carry, right? Is everyone agreeing with that?
Yes.
Right? Okay. So if you can carry 1 kg, right? If I fill all of these boxes, all of these parts, the cost will be 36 rupees, right? Right? This plus this plus this plus this plus this plus this is equal to 36. How many parts are there? There are 6. So each one will have how many? 36 divided by 6, no? That will be the cost of each part, right? Is everyone sure? Divided by 6, right? See, we have 6 parts. Altogether, they cost 36 rupees. Altogether. So, how much will be the cost for 1?
6 rupees.
That is the answer. It's 36 divided by 6, correct? Are you guys understanding or not?
Yes.
Pakka, 36 by 6 is the correct answer? For one part only. For one, just for this. And it is right, we have 6 parts, altogether they cost 36. For one of them, we can say 36 divided by 6 is the cost, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the cost for this is how much? What is 36 divided by 6? What is the answer to that?
6.
Right, so the cost of this one block is 6 rupees. Right. Cost of this block is also 6 rupees. Cost of this block is also 6. This is also 6. This is also 6. Hena?
Yes.
Everyone is agreeing?
Yes.
Okay, so now we are asking for 4 parts. So what will be the cost? This is 6. This is also 6. This is also 6.
24.
24 is right?
Yes.
Addition of 6 4 times, or we can directly say 6 into 4, right?
Yes.
Is equal to 24. Correct. 24 is the correct answer. And what is the easier way to do this? Same method that I discussed earlier, just earlier. Can I write 4 by 6 into 36? Do you think you'll get the correct answer here?
Yeah.
What does 4 by 6 mean? We have divided into 6 groups, right?
Yes.
And selected how many groups?
4.
We have divided into 6 groups. What is the first step? We divide 36 by 6. What is 36 upon 6?
6.
The first step is 36 divided by 6. What is the answer?
6.
6 is then multiplied by 4. What is the answer?
24.
So we are getting the answer 24, Anna?
Yes.
So what is the step? We divide by the denominator. We divide this. Then whatever the answer we get, we multiply with the numerator. Are you understanding?
Yes.
And it makes sense. Huh? What does the denominator mean? Denominator means we divide into that many parts. So that is why we're dividing 36 by 6. And what does the numerator mean? We are selecting 4 parts. So we're multiplying by 4 because we selected 4. Hai na? Ye samajh aa gaya?
Yes.
Sabko samajh aaya ki nahi? You have to be loud now. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? So we always, denominator ko we always divide. We divide by the denominator, we multiply by the numerator. Mesha. Okay? Alright. So now let's go to the next question. How many hours are there in a day? 24, right? So there's this kid Raj. Okay, Raj spends 8 hours sleeping, 6 hours in school, 1 hour doing his homework, 3 hours playing, and 6 hours for other activities. What fraction of the day does he spend in each activity? You guys have to try it in your notebook now. All of you just write the answer down. Has everyone done it? Because I see a lot of people sitting there not doing anything.
Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, have they tried? Say all of them.
Not there.
Oh, okay. So you guys have tried, right? We shall discuss. Shall we discuss?
Yes.
Okay, now some of you wanted to answer now. Can you tell me the answer for sleeping? Just for sleeping.
8 of 24.
Good job. What about school?
6 upon 24.
What about homework?
1 upon 24.
Playing.
3 upon 24.
Good. And finally, for other activities.
6 upon 24.
Okay. And what is the fraction if I add all of them?
24.
And what does 24 upon 24 hours mean?
One day.
Right. So I didn't even need to use this, that means. I was going to explain through this. Okay, so all of you got it. Good job. What about this? Now try the second question.